What's going on? So I'm just gonna play this song, get a little worship going on. Hold on 1 second. There it go. Just a little worship music going on real quick. Hey, what's going on, chill? So I entitled this Restore My Soul. So for some of y'all that don't know, this will be my last video for a while. So the lesson today will be about restoration and just asking the Father to restore me, you know, because I'm always pouring into family, friends, and y'all here on Vigo and YouTube and TikTok, Snapchat, Facebook, and it just got to the point to where now I'm exhausted and I have to allow the Lord to pour back into me. So I'm going to take a break for a while. I'm going to just spend time with God, you know, early in the mornings. And I encourage y'all to do the same, man, because this is not easy. It's not easy when you don't have a lot, but you have enough. But you're asking God for a lot of things and God to do a lot of things in my life. So gotta spend time with him. Gotta allow him to pour back into me as I pour it out into everyone else. I've always been a helping hand to everyone else, always praying for someone, always, you know, going where they want me to go to, you know, watch them, record them, or what have you, or help them move, whatever it is. And just not being poured back into, you know, when it came to family, friends, ex-wife, children, just always being that helping hand, you know, being that servant. And now I'm just like, you know, I gotta take time out to myself. I can't keep on doing this and expecting, you know, God to do something in my life. So I literally have to step back and allow him to fill me back up. And Father's Heart Ministry is right on time with it too, because it said something this morning, and I didn't even read it this morning. I read it this afternoon when I was at IHOP with my sister. And so, yeah, it is hard for the chosen ones. Oh, I'm not going to give up. Never going to give up on God. Never. Not ever will give up on my Heavenly Father. I can't do that. So this message won't be long today. Give or take, it may be about 10 to 15 minutes. But I brought some scriptures for restoration. And then y'all know we always start with prayer first and foremost, and we end with prayer. And then once we start with prayer, we get that finished, then we'll move into the Father's Heart Ministry. From the Father's Heart Ministry, I'll bring you all the scriptures about restoration. And I hope that y'all take this into consideration, even for yourselves. You know, it's not a selfish act to take time out to yourself, take time to spend with the Lord, to allow God to fix you up. You know, just like Joseph, just like David, just like any man in the Bible, they had to go away for some time and spend time with God and allow God to fix them up for what's coming up next. Allow God to pour back into them what's needed in them, because man can't do this. Man can't do what God can do. So you have to definitely spend time with your Creator. So, Father, first and foremost, I just got to say thank you for allowing me to wake up, but not to give up, Father God, not to give up on my calling, not to give up on your children, and not to give up on you, first and foremost. You know, I don't want to give up on you So I have to get restored. You know, I have to take some time to evaluate some things, to allow you to do some things that only you can do. So Father, I pray that this message even reaches your children, that they would take time out to themselves and spend time with you as well, Father God, because this is not an easy walk. This is not an easy task. It's not easy shoes to fill. So Father, I just thank you for choosing me, for allowing me to be able to take a step back and stop pouring so much into other people and allow me to get poured back into, Father God. Shalom, Brother JT. And I just want to say thank you. I just want to say, you know, I love you for showing me this word, for allowing me to have brothers and sisters that are pouring back into me, that are encouraging me and pushing me, Father God. But I need you. I need you first and foremost before it all, because you created the sons and the daughters. You created everything that I've been asking you for, that I've been wanting in prayers, and I've been writing down. Father, I know that wanting all of those things is going to take time. It's going to take time to where there's a shifting that needs to take place. There's a shifting in the atmosphere that has to take place. There's a shifting in me, because you're restoring a lot of things in my life, in my body, in my mind, and just my daily walk, in the way that I look, in the way that I carry myself. And Father, the only way to get that is to sit with you. So Father, I thank you, I love you, and I praise you, and I magnify you. In Jesus Christ's holy, mighty, precious name I pray. Amen, amen, so be it, and amen. So let's read the Father's Heart Ministry. I want y'all to hear this, man. It blessed me to hear this. Okay, so the Father's Heart Ministry, the prophetic word for today, June 27th, and it says this: the Father says today, I am restoring your soul. By my powerful love, I am drawing you into the awakening realm of your first love with me. Return therefore to your first love and let me heal you and restore you to a place that is higher and better than any other place or time you have been previously. So I was thinking about this, y'all. I was thinking about this long and hard, like for the past few days, like, what do I need to do? Like, I need to step away. Do I need to step away from Bego? Do I need to step away from YouTube? Do I need to step away from TikTok? Do I need to step away from family? Do I need to step away? What the heck? Do I need to step away from friends? Do I need to step away from the world? And literally today, I said, yes, I need to take those steps. So when I read this, I was like, dang, God is talking straight to me. It says, return therefore to your first love and let me heal you and restore you to a place that is higher and better than any other place or time you have been previously. Now, it's not talking about restoring me back to, my ex-wife, or restoring me back to my mother or my father or my brothers. No, it's what it's literally saying is restoring me back to when I lost myself when I was a child. You know, I lost a lot of things. I felt like I missed out on a lot of things because of the things that I indulged in. And so now I need God to restore all of that back that was taken from me, that the canker worm has stolen. So it says, my restoration creates within you the very blueprint of my design for your life. You have been created and called for a glorious purpose, and the pathway of the return is through the doorway of first love. First love is God. We must first love God more than anything in the world. We must first love our creator, the one who created it all, the one who brought us into this world and who will take us out. I would be again your first love, is what the Father says. For I will take preeminence in your thoughts and in your actions and cause your soul to be filled with my holy passion for my presence and my purpose. So God says that he will restore everything, not only my thoughts, but my actions. He will cause my soul to be filled with holy passion, with his presence and his purpose in my life, and even in the same in yours. You shall know my holy desire for you. The Father says you will know his holy desire for you and respond with the fire and the flame of pure, passionate first love that you once had. Respond in heartfelt earnest to my call to return to that love, and I will make it more glorious, more intimate, and more joyous than you have ever imagined possible. My beloved, you will say with all sincerity of heart and soul, I am my beloved's and he is mine, says the Father. I will say that I am my Father's son, that I have been restored by my heavenly Father, that I have received a blessing that only the Father can give me. No man can give this to me. No woman can give this to me. I'm not chasing my father, my earthly father anymore. I'm not chasing my mother anymore. I'm not chasing my brother anymore, my sister anymore. I'm not chasing my ex-wife anymore. I'm not chasing women anymore. I'm not chasing after men to do this with me anymore. I'm just going to chase after God and allow God to do what God said he will do. Go with me to Joel chapter 2, and let's start at verse 25. Joel. Man, where is it? Okay. Joel chapter 2, verse 25. Let's start at verse 25. It says, and I will restore to you the years that the locust hath eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you, and you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God that hath dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed, and you shall know that I am in the midst of Israel and none else, and my people shall never be ashamed. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. This is what I want God to do in my life. This is what I would like God to do in your life. But only God can do this, and we gotta get away from the world. We have to get away from social media. We have to get away from a lot of things. Because if we're doing too many things, God can't do nothing right then. Because he doesn't have your attention. This does. Social media has your attention. Your family has your attention. Your kids have your attention. Your wife has your attention. Your husband has your attention. Sometimes you just gotta take time to yourself and get away from everything else. Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 17. verse 17. And it says, "For I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord, because they called thee an outcast, saying, This is Zion, whom no man seek after." They did, man. God says he will restore my health. He will restore your health. He will heal your wounds and my wounds. The places that you've been hurt, only God can heal those wounds that other people can't see. Your heart, your body, the places you've been broken at, that somebody tried to tear you down. God can heal all of that. And he says, he will heal your wounds, saith the Lord, because they called thee an outcast. They called me an outcast. They called you an outcast. They called you crazy. They called you crazy for praising God. They called you crazy for acknowledging the Father. They called you crazy for wanting God to restore your life. They called you crazy because they said, oh no, God can't do that. God can't restore your body. God can't restore you back to your youth days. God can't restore your hair, my hair. God can't restore your whole body. Any place that you've been hurt, God can't make you grow. God can do anything that you ask for. If you just have faith as a mustard seed, just like the woman who had the issue of blood, what did she say? She said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I will be healed. And all she did was touch the hem of Christ's garment. And what happened? She was healed instantly. Not later on, but instantly. Because she believed that all she had to do was touch the hem of his garment. She was healed by her faith and believing that all she had to do was touch him. She was already healed because her faith was activated. Verse 18, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring again the captivity of Jacob's tents and have mercy on his dwelling places, and the city shall be builded upon her own heap, and the palace shall remain after the manner thereof. God is going to do the same thing that he did to Jacob, that he did to Joseph, that he did with Moses, that he did with Samson, that he did with Solomon, that he did with any of them. Christ, you can have all those things. God will do all of the things that you ask for, exceedingly and above all that you could ever imagine or even think of. Psalms 23 and 3. He says, okay, now I'm going to just read Psalms 23, and I'm going to read the fullness of it, starting at verse 1, and we'll go all the way to verse 6. And everybody should know this. It says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. God will do all of that. That prayer right there is so powerful. God will do anything that you ask for, because the Lord is your shepherd and you shall not want. He makes you to lie down in green pastures, or he makes you to lie down in your bed and be at peace in your bed. He leads you beside still waters. You can walk past all of this stuff. You can go past all of this stuff and nothing is going to touch you with a 10-foot pole. You can walk past your enemies and they won't do nothing to you. So leading you beside the still waters is like walking down that beach and there's a tsunami or something coming, and God will calm the storm. He will tell the water what to do. Still waters. Waters that ain't moving. I mean, they may be moving like as far as the waves and everything, but it ain't gonna get that crazy. Just like how he did with Moses. And he put that staff, that rod in the water, and it parted the Red Sea. It was still for a moment while they passed through. He restores my soul. He will restore my soul. He will restore your soul, everybody's soul that looks to God for the answer. He will restore your soul. He leads you in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. He will lead you. He will guide you. He will protect you. He will order your steps in the way that you should go. He prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He will prepare everything for you. A table of this gift or this business, this clothing line, this ministry. Anything that you ask for, this home, this car, these places, any place you want to go, God will make sure that he puts a table before your enemies and they will be your footstool. In the presence of my enemies, he anoints my head with oil and my cup runs over. He anoints my head with oil. He anoints your head with oil and it will never stop flowing. It will never stop. It will just keep on running over. The blessings are just going to keep on coming. Y'all know how they be talking about make it rain and all of that stuff? The blessings just going to keep on coming. And I'm not just talking about in finances. I'm talking about in so many things that you will know that it ain't nothing but God that did all of this. The people will know. Your enemies will know. And some of them will turn from their wicked ways and follow you, because they know what God you serve and how powerful that God is. The ultimate God, our Heavenly Father. Psalms 51 and 12. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise. For thou desirest not sacrifice, else would I give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. The sacrifices of God are broken spirit, are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. O God, thou wilt not despise. Do good in thy good pleasure unto Zion. Build thou the walls of Jerusalem. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifices of righteousness, with burnt offering and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. Brokenness. We all broken. We all got some stuff going on. We got a broken spirit. We all got something that broke our spirit. And God desires that from you because he wants to restore you. He wants to fix you up. He wants to show you that everything that tried to break you or did break you, he's going to restore all of that. He's going to fix you up in a mighty way. He's going to do something so powerful, your enemies will be converted to where they start praising God, start crying out to God, thanking God, because they want that too. Nobody wants to be broken in this world. Nobody wants to be hurt. Nobody wants to lose their child or lose their wife or lose their husband, lose their mother, lose their father, lose their business, lose their ministry, lose their house, lose their car, get repossessed and all that. Don't nobody want to go to prison. Nobody wants to bury their son or their daughter. But those things broke you, just like they broke me. So you got to take some time. You got to get with God and allow God to fix you up. Allow God to pour back into you, because he requires the sacrifice of this world. He requires you to sacrifice this world, sacrifice your life that you knew, to come to him so he can show you who you truly are. The old you has passed away, but the new you will live. That old me is dead. That old man that I used to be, that old young man that I was, all of that stuff, the things that I did in the past, all of that stuff is dead and it's no longer. I will tell my story. I will tell my story to prisoners. I will tell my story to young men and to young women as well. I will tell my story to the world. And it be nothing but the truth, because the truth shall make you free. Romans 15 and 13. How much time I got left? Okay. Romans 15 and 13. I got two more scriptures and then we'll be done. All right, here we go. Verse 13 says, "Now the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that you may abound in hope through the power of the Holy Ghost." Now what? The God of hope. What is hope? Hope is faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not yet seen. So the God of hope. When we be hoping for something, we be hoping for God to do something in our life. We be hoping for God to fix that man, fix that woman, fix us. We be hoping for God to bless us with some finances. We be hoping that we can win the lottery. We be hoping that we can have our wife. We be hoping that your husband don't go out there and be doing wrong. You be hoping, you be asking God, like, "God, please don't let him do this. I hope he ain't doing what I think he doing. I hope she ain't doing what I think she doing. I hope my kids ain't doing what I think they doing." Y'all know how we talk to our kids sometimes, like, "I know you're not doing what I think you're doing." Or even you talk to your husband or your wife, like, "I know you're not finna, what? Are you serious?" "I hope you're not finna do what I think you're finna do." Hey, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not yet seen. Faith without works is dead. That hope will fill you with all joy and peace in believing. God will make sure that you have a smile on your face. That joy is in your heart. Joy comes in the morning. That you will believe that it's nothing but God. All of that. God will make sure that you have all of that. All that you could ever ask for. And all that you can think of. Even some things you can't even think of, God want to bless you with. "And I myself also am persuaded of you, my brethren, that you also are full of goodness, filled with all knowledge, able also to admonish one another." We supposed to do this, brothers. We supposed to help one another. We supposed to go in there in the prisons and preach the gospel to these young men. To these men in there that feel like they have nothing to live for. Feel like they'll never get out. But thank you so much, because this is exactly what I'm called to do. And I know it's about to happen at a rapid pace. So I thank Bego. You know, I thank Bego. I thank God for, you know, allowing Bego to actually banana me for 10 years. Thank you. I appreciate it. Gave me time to really think and evaluate some things. Thank you to my family, to my friends, to the ones that didn't believe in me, to the ones that don't believe in me, to the ones that don't even share my lives, the ones that don't share my my YouTube platform or my TikTok platform or Instagram or whatever it is, whatever platform I'm on. Thank you. I appreciate you. I really do. Thank you for not subscribing, you know, because I always had a vision, like, if I can just get this many subscribers, I can help my family. I can help all of them. But you know what? Thank y'all, because I want y'all to keep that same energy. I want you to keep that same energy when these blessings get to coming and God get to doing things in my life and y'all get to seeing all this. Please keep that same energy. Keep that same energy. I'm going to love you. I am. I'm going to love you. But you're going to have to cry out to God. You're going to have to cry out to God. You're going to have to ask God for your blessing. Maybe I am going to be the blessing to you. But my answers only come from God. Don't ask me for no more money. I'm sorry. I can't help nobody else. Don't ask me for money. You know, giving away $2,500 to somebody just to use me. Just to use me like crazy. Pouring into folks all the time. Helping them. And ain't nobody helping me. And it's no shot at anybody. I'm thankful. I am so thankful. I'm not even mad. I'm not upset. None of that. I'm glad. To the mother of my children, I'm glad. I surely am. I'm glad. For all the people that I help, I'm so happy. Because guess what? I'm going to play a song for you. Not this one. I am so glad. Sure enough. There we go. Play some William Murphy. But yeah, I am. I'm glad. My dad, all of them. Never gonna become bitter. I'm nowhere near bitter. I'm so happy. I'm full of joy because I know God is getting ready to do something amazing, man. I'm telling you. Be sad for what? Be bitter for what? Listen to this song. What I need to be mad for? What I need to be bitter for? It's my season. Sure have. God got a purpose, y'all. And I know he's able. I got some seeds that I planted in the ground. No more stressing. And I'm knowing. And it's showing. Y'all, I'm telling you, man, this is my season. The enemy can't stop me. The enemy can't stop me, man. I'm telling you, I'm gonna keep on going. Whether you jump out of my life, whether you end my life, I'm gonna keep on going. You ain't gotta like me. You ain't gotta love me. Because everything is gonna what? Everything is working. Together for my good. Everything is working. Together for my good. Everything is working. Together for my good. Say it, y'all. It's good. It's good. It's good. I'm telling y'all, you gotta know about it. Hey, and not only that, look. Shout out to the folks that talked down on me on Bigo. You know, the ones that had everything bad to say about a brother. The you know, the Hebrew Israelites, brothers and sisters that was talking down on me. Hey, thank you. Thank you. Thank y'all. I thank all my haters. I do. I thank all y'all for everything that you said and that you thought about me. That you thought that I was lusting after women. You thought that I was trying to holler at every single woman on here. Nah, I'm good. Nope. It ain't true. It ain't true. But there is one that I truly did pursue. I did. Had no problem with that one though. I'm good. I'm gonna keep on going. I'm gonna keep on going. Cause ain't nobody gonna stop me. Only thing can stop me is me. So like I said, man, it's my season for grace, for favor. This is my season to reap what I have sown. And it's a lot. But I'm just going to take some time away from Bigo, away from YouTube, away from TikTok, away from Instagram, away from Twitter, away from my podcast, away from Rizzle, away from Facebook, away from Snapchat, away from family, away from friends. I'm just going to work and I'm going to do what God has called me to do. I'm going to spend time with my Heavenly Father more than anything. I'll be back. Trust me, I'll be back. Don't trust my words. Just go off of my actions. You'll see me. You'll see me. I ain't going to look like this no more. I'm not going to look like this. Y'all gonna see a totally different man. A totally different knowledge. A totally different Lamel. A totally different Pastor White. Or Pastor Knowledge. Or some of y'all call it Brother Jamie. Whatever it is, you're gonna see a totally different me. I may be unrecognizable. You might not even recognize as me anymore. I don't know. We're going to see what God going to do, y'all. We're going to see. Last chapter is Isaiah chapter 61, verse 7. And this is the last one. Hey, get off of here. Verse 7. It says, "For your shame you shall have double, and for your confusion they shall rejoice in their portion. Therefore, in their land they shall possess the double. Everlasting joy shall be unto them. For I, the Lord, love judgment. I hate robbery for burnt offering. I will direct their work in truth, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. And their seed shall be known among the Gentiles, and their offspring among the people. All that see them shall acknowledge them, that they are the seed which the Lord hath blessed." That's talking about more than me. That's talking about a lot of us. They will know that it was from our Heavenly Father. But I never lost faith, y'all. Ain't that what Marvin Sapp says? So glad I made it. I made it through. I remember, mine wasn't recent, but I remember being incarcerated. It's not a pretty sight. And I don't want no man, no woman, no child to ever feel like that. To feel like nobody loves you. To feel like that you have nobody to call on. So that's why I gotta start my prison ministry. Because I want to help those in there. Give them an opportunity to do something better. So it's time to step away. Same here, man. When I was in jail, that's when I started crying out to God. You know, and I got so close to him, man. I got so close to him. I was able to hear his voice. I was able to hear his voice to where... I made a promise to God. I said, God, whatever you want me to do, whatever you ask me to do, I'll do it. The man of God you desire, that you want me to be, you desire for me to be. The father you desire me to be. The brother you desire for me to be. The friend you desire for me to be. The husband you desire for me to be. I'll do it all for you. I just need you to get me out of here. And do you know that God got me out of there in 7 days? Completion. 7 days. See, people don't know what you've been through. See, people really don't know what all we done been through. What the people that you talk to, what they've been through. They don't understand. The government don't understand, you know, some of what you've been through. We get locked up. They don't care what we've been through. They just want the money. They don't care. They give two craps about what you've been through. You committed a crime, you finna do the time, and you finna make me some money. It's always been about the money. They don't care about the NBA players, the NFL players, track stars, actors, anything. You commit a crime, if you ain't got the money to pay for that crime, to get out of, you know, whatever debt you have with them, oh, you going to lockdown. It's always been about the money. But us down here, we get more time. You wanna know why? Because we don't have the finances for it. We don't. The lawyer is about his money. If you ain't got no money for him or her to help you in your case, you might as well just keep the little money you got. Go on in there, do whatever time you got to do, and make sure your family is taken care of with the finances. Scrap the lawyer. Because the lawyer worked with them. Some of them, not all of them. That's why we need to start raising up lawyers and doctors. Real ones. Ones that come from our neck of the woods. Forget NBA players and NFL players and all this other stuff. What are they doing for us? Some of them do something, but most time they always giving back to a charity that they tell them to give to. I don't never see them go back into their own neighborhoods and pour into them. I don't never see that. Not a lot of times. But they got this gift. They got all this stuff that they was blessed with. And they so focused on their career that they ain't even trying to help nobody. They don't even want to acknowledge God. They want to look up and thank God when they hit a shot, when they win that trophy, when they get the hold of the butt of their head. But half the time, you don't see them praising God like that. Mark Jackson got blackballed because he brought God into basketball. He can't even be a coach in the NBA because they don't like that he be spreading the word, spreading the gospel. If you look at it, man, even in the school system, they don't want you praising God. They don't want you acknowledging God. They took it out of school. They took it out of the work environment. They took anything that had to do with God out of it. Because they knew, oh man, these people, these black people, like, they just be praising God and thanking God, like, and he be doing stuff for them. So we got to take this out of them. We got to make a law against this. We got to make a law against this. Forget that law. Forget that law. That law is jacked up. Why you think the world is the way that it is right now? Coronavirus and everything. Now look at everybody praising God, thanking God. Then you got folks talking down on God. You got folks talking about Christianity. You got folks talking about Hebrew Israelites. You got folks talking about Muslims. You got folks talking about Catholics. You got folks talking about Seventh-day Adventists. You got folks talking about atheists. But that's because they don't believe. They don't believe in God. They believe in some other being. So we got to make sure that we get God back into it, man. Start praising God. If you're going to kill me for praising God, you're going to lock me up for praising God, so be it. Shoot. Be just like Joseph. Be just like Joseph that got his blessing while he was in prison. The gifts are without, the gift is without repentance. Remember that. So in a nutshell, all I'm saying, man, is time to step away. So let's pray it out, and I'll see y'all when I see y'all. I do, man. I love y'all. I really do. I love each and every one of y'all. I may not know you personally like that, but I got the love of God in me to love you unconditionally. Whether I know you on the app or whether I know you outside the app, whether you're a brother to me or a sister to me, a friend to me, whatever it is, I got that much love for y'all. And that's real. Father, I thank you that I don't look like what I've been through. I thank you that you're raising me up to be the man that you have called me to be, the man of integrity, of good character, of you, Father God, to look like you, to love like you, to bless like you, to do what you have called me to do because you called me to this ministry. You called me to you, and I answered that call, and I'm going to continue to answer that call and have a relationship with you, Father God. It ain't about religion for me. It's about a relationship with you of obedience. So I thank you, Father, again, because when I was young, I was dumb, and I was making dumb decisions, and I wasn't serving you. I was serving the enemy and didn't realize it. But now that I know better, I got to do better. And I got to tell people how to defeat the enemy. And I thank you for it, Father God, as you've given me the word, you've given me this Bible. I thank you for my grandfather that you placed in my life at an early age to giving me the Bible, Father God. I thank you for even my mother, my father, my brother, my sister, my aunts, my uncles, my cousins, my friends, my family, and even my enemies. Because I still gotta love them too, Father God, just like you love them. You love all of us. And that's a command that I stand by, is to love them no matter what. Even the ones that wrong us, Father God, the ones that kill us in the street, the ones that lock us up and throw us in jail. Even the government, Father God, just everyone. We gotta learn how to love. Because love conquers all. I love you. I praise you. I magnify you. Teach me how to love you every day, Father God. Teach your children, your sons and your daughters, how to love you every day. How to love like you. How to be more Christ-like. We give you all honor, glory, and praise. In Jesus Christ's mighty, holy, precious name, I pray. Amen, amen. So be it, and amen. Shalom, brothers and sisters, kings and queens. I love y'all. Blessings to y'all. Knowledge.